I think it's safe to say, for the most part, that fans of a video game franchise will be excited no matter what and when a new game is announced. However, there have been plenty of instances where a new game in a series was announced and it was immediately given negative feedback from the fans, be it because of a change in direction, an untrusted development team, or any other number of factors. Fans aren't always going to be happy when you announce a new entry into their favorite series. What's up, guys? Jimmy here. Welcome to Chaos Top 10s, and today we're going to be taking a look at and counting down 10 games that fans hated even before the game launched. And just to be clear, this list is not going to be looking at whether or not the game was good. Some of these games actually ended up being good, some of them were bad, but that's not what matters. This list is of those games that were hated by fans of the series before the game even got a chance. We are running a $200 Amazon gift card giveaway the entire month. All you have to do to enter is like this video, be subscribed, turn on your notifications, and leave a comment why you want to win it with your Twitter handle attached. I will announce the winner at the end of the month on Twitter. Kicking off our list at number 10 is Sonic Boom Rise of Lyric. And Sonic has had a really, really tough time recently. Most everybody knows that. Ever since the 2006 release, the franchise has been struggling, and this has heavily contributed to why fans are so skeptical of Sonic Boom from the very beginning. Not only was this a game going to feature non-traditional Sonic gameplay, but all of the characters were redesigned, and to be honest, the new look was pretty terrible. There was pretty much no hype surrounding Sonic Boom, and that was due to all of the unwelcome changes, and go figure, the game was hammered by critics when it came out for being strange gameplay from what it was supposed to be, bad writing, level design, and a multitude of technical problems. So Sonic Boom never really had a chance to boom. At number 9, we have a game that came out actually not too long ago, merging the world of the Mushroom Kingdom with that of the Rabbids, who had first appeared as characters in the Rayman series of games. I'm talking about Mario plus Rabbids, the Kingdom Battle. Fans were extremely skeptical of this new game for tons of warranted reasons. First, it was going to be a turn-based RPG as opposed to a traditional Mario or Rabbids game. Then, you had the people who thought that the two characters didn't really fit together, and you had the people who weren't happy with the fact that the game was going to be developed by Ubisoft and that Nintendo wasn't even going to touch the game itself. Whenever you do a crossover game like this, people are definitely going to be unhappy, especially when you're putting a character as beloved as Mario in the hands of a company like Ubisoft, who doesn't exactly have the best reputation with gamers. Whenever you reboot a series as legendary and as beloved as Devil May Cry, you are going to anger some fans in the process. I'm talking about our number 8 entry today, Devil May Cry. Now, DMC was released revealed in 2010, and it was instantly hated by fans due to all the changes in style. Dante, the main character, was completely reworked and visually, and his personality was different, which angered fans not only because he was deleting a character they loved, but also because the new Dante was very whiny and just annoying. The combat was also being reworked in the ways that fans were not happy with, as the Devil May Cry series has always been known for its unique style of gameplay. All in all, fans of the Devil May Cry series weren't happy with the complete reworking of the franchise, and the reboot, it failed. It helped contribute to the game's failure in sales expectations. At number 7, we have Mass Effect Andromeda, and after the insane success of the Mass Effect trilogy and the incredible following that it created, it is hard to believe that anyone would be opposed to the continuation, and that's what happened with Andromeda. When it was first announced, fans were skeptical but excited to see that the series would be continued. Everybody would be. However, all of that changed when the demos were first shown off and more info came out about the team working on the game. Unlike the previous games, Andromeda was not going to be developed by the experienced BioWare employees. Instead, it would be a brand new team handling the game. A team that not only had no experience with game development, but many of the employees had a reputation in the community for being pretty unpleasant and unprofessional online. Concerns only got worse when the demos were released, and it was revealed just how sloppy the game looked and played. Not to mention that EA and BioWare were selling a collector's edition of Andromeda that did not even include the game, making the whole thing just feel like a quick cash grab. Okay, at number 6, this game is great, and it's also the sequel to another great game, Left 4 Dead 2. However, It earns a spot on this list due to Valve going back on their word after the release of the first Left 4 Dead and back after the first game came out. Valve stated they were going to keep on supporting it with new content and expansions, but less than a year later, Valve turned around and announced the sequel, essentially rendering the first game moot and all of the expansions you bought pointless. Things only got worse when it was revealed that the gameplay and graphics of the second game were nearly identical to the first, leading many to believe that Left 4 Dead 2 was simply a collection of DLC that was going to be released for Left 4 Dead 1. But Valve decided to just package it all together as a brand new game instead of letting players just download it piece by piece. If that is the case, I'm sure that's alleged. That's pretty crappy. Cracking into the top 5 today, we have Star Wars Battlefront 2 2017, which is out any day now. EA's new Battlefront series definitely isn't making all the fans happy, and that's not a mystery. The upcoming Battlefront 2 was initially being seen as a correction of the first game's shortcomings, but after the open beta, there are some fans that were pretty pissed. While Battlefront 2 will not have DLC packs or a season pass, the beta revealed that character and weapon progression in Battlefront 2 will be entirely based on RNG loot boxes, as opposed to actual player skill, leading to many calling it a full-priced pay-to-win game. While we don't know for sure if that's the case, all signs are pointing towards it being true, and I really, really hope that EA changes it before launch this November, which is actually a couple days away. However, this is a list of games that angered the fans before launch, and the upcoming Battlefront 2 easily earns a spot on this list due to EA once again demanding an insane amount of extra money from the player after they already spent $60 on the core game itself. Capcom definitely angered a lot of Resident Evil fans with the release of Resident Evil 5 in 2009 as the series ditched much of the horror theme and went just for plain action. And now, we're going to talk about Resident Evil 6. Things only got worse when Operation Raccoon City was released in March of 2012, which was not only, it was even more of an action and less horror than the other one. It was just straight up a bad game. Capcom really needed to turn things around with RE6 if they were going to win back the fans of the legendary horror series, and that's definitely not what happened at all. It was revealed to be another action-heavy Resident Evil title, as opposed to the classic horror game that nearly everybody had been asking for. Thankfully, RE7 was able to put the series back on track because Capcom was really sitting in some hot water after RE5, 6, and Raccoon City. At number 3, we have Halo 5. Now, 343 Industries was given a super difficult task after Bungie left the Halo franchise. Halo 4 was widely hated throughout the community for its changes to the gameplay, as it was clearly an effort to try to grab some of the Call of Duty players as opposed to continue to please Halo fans. 343 chugged right along though, and they continued the Master Chief story with Halo 5 Guardians, claiming they were going to bring back what made Halo great. As I'm sure most of you already know, that's not exactly what happened. Not only did Halo 5 have probably the worst campaign of any Halo game to date, but it definitely did not return Halo to the roots that 343 had promised. 343 really needs to blow us out of the water with Halo 6, or the series could end up in trouble and it could end up dying. At number 2, we have Destiny 2, and the first Destiny game had a pretty rocky lifespan. It launched, it was unfinished, it was hated, then it slowly worked its way back into the good graces of the community. However, fans were pretty furious when it was revealed that Destiny's 10-year plan was going to be interrupted by a sequel just a few years into the first game's existence. Things only got worse after the Destiny 2 beta, as the gameplay was almost completely untouched and hardly anything was different from the first game. Not to mention the fact that it was running at 30 FPS. Needless to say, people weren't exactly happy with Destiny 2's reveal or the first impressions that the beta gave. So I want to know, in the comments, are you enjoying Destiny 2? If you guys know me, you probably already guessed this was going to be number 1, okay? Call of Duty Infinite Warfare. And it has to be number 1. It has one of the most disliked videos in the history of YouTube. IW was absolutely destroyed by the Call of Duty community. People were sick and tired of the futuristic COD games, and they wanted a return to form. And when the Infinite Warfare trailer came out, it just seemed like Activision was refusing to listen at the time to what people wanted. I know that's not exactly what happened, and that Infinite Warfare was in development before the cries for boots on the ground began, but the timing of everything is really what killed IW and ended up getting it on this list. Had Infinite Warfare been released in 2014, or maybe even 2015, reception probably would have been much better. However, it was revealed in 2016, 3 years since the last boots on the ground game, and that is what ended up getting it ripped apart by the community. There you have it, my friends. Those are 10 games that fans hated before they even launched. Let me know some others that should have been on the list. There's a playlist below if you want to check out the others. Drop a like on your way out, and I'll see you tomorrow for a brand new video.